Hey, happy new year and welcome to another Merchant Center Mastery video. I'm hoping to actually record some more videos this year and get back into it with this channel because I think it's really valuable for people. I've been getting some great questions and some interest. So I want to start off with a very short video. This short video though could change your life because you may have been opted in automatically or maybe you took over an account that was Google Merchant Center Next. Google Merchant Center Next, I do have an entire clip where I go through that, all the different settings, that sort of thing, so you can go check that out. But Google Merchant Center Next is Google's newest iteration of their user interface, their UI for Merchant Center. And this is, Google has told us numerous times, this is eventually going to replace Google Merchant Center. So at some point, you do kind of need to get to know it. But it's not ready yet. It's not ready for prime time. I was recently, I think just about a month ago, chatting with Ginny Marvin, who is the ads liaison for Google on Twitter, and she was noting that there are still plans to get feed rules in that I think, now I'm trying to remember this, but I'm pretty sure she had noted like they're not going to force anyone over to that until, you know, that sort of thing is more locked in prime time. So that's really good news because if you had been running feed rules, you were probably rightfully nervous about like what's going to happen to my feed if they just switch me over from Merchant Center to Merchant Center Next. Be assured that you can switch back to Merchant Center. The point of this video, the point of this very short video is to show you how to do that because it's actually really frustrating. It can be really annoying at times. So you may be looking at your Merchant Center Next and you may be trying to just looking through all the things and cannot find how to switch back to Merchant Center, to the original Merchant Center, good old classic, the one that we all know and love. And here's where you go. You do not go to the settings. You do not go to the settings tab, which doesn't make any sense to me, right? I think that's why so many people struggle finding out how you switch back. You do not go to the settings tab. You can spend all your life checking out personal preferences and general account options. It's in none of those. It's actually in the help tab. And right down at the bottom, you switch to the Use Classic Merchant Center and you'll go back to it. I'm not actually going to select that because I do want to leave this specific client in for Merchant Center Next because it's pretty simple and it allows us to get access to Merchant Center Next and kind of see what's going on. But oftentimes we will switch back to that. That classic, it does ask you, and then unless they've changed something recently, once you click on it, it does warn you and say, hey, you're not going to be able to switch back to Merchant Center Next once you switch to classic. Just be aware of that. If for some reason you want to go back and forth, you actually can't do that. Once you go from classic Merchant Center back to Merchant Center Next, you're stuck in classic Merchant Center. A great place to be stuck, in my opinion, but there it is. So that's where you go. You do not go into settings. You go into the help. You click it, you do the classic Merchant Center, and you get back to the Merchant Center that you know and love. Hope this short but informative video was helpful for you. Thanks so much. Subscribe, and we'll keep you updated on all the Merchant Center stuff that you need to know.